यूनिट 3 ट्रांसफार्मर्स लेक्चर 14 ऑटो ट्रांसफार्मर। टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज ऑटो ट्रांसफार्मर। ए ट्रांसफार्मर जनरली इज अ स्टैटिक डिवाइस यूज्ड टू कन्वर्ट हाई वोल्टेजेस टू लो वोल्टेजेस एंड वाइस वर्सा विथ कॉन्स्टेंट फ्रीक्वेंसी। दिस इज वन ऑफ द transformer that you come across near your homes, apartments, in your lane. We are looking after what is basically a transformer is. Why do we need a transformer at the generating stations? In this diagram, as you can see, the blue line represents the transmission, green represents the distribution, and black represents the generation, and circles these represents the transformers. So this is the generation station and this is the generator, step up transformer, and this is the transmission, and here substation step down transformer, and this green color is the distribution. Sub transmission customer 26 kV, 69 kV, primary customer 13 kV, 4 kV, secondary customer 120 volts, 240 volts. As you can see, at the generating stations the power is generated and the voltage has to be stepped up and it has to be transmitted. During this transmission, you also need a transformer, and at the distribution end, you need a distribution transformer. This is why we need a transformer in order to reduce the losses and for better efficiency transmission. This is a general representation of a transformer. This is the core of the transformer. This is primary turns and this is the secondary turns, and Vp is the primary voltage. This is a primary coil that is wound on this limb, and this is the secondary winding that is wound on this limb. This is called a secondary coil and this is called as primary coil. This is transformer general basic construction, and you can represent this as like this. The magnetic core, the lines represent the magnetic core, and this is the secondary of the transformer. This is the primary of the transformer. You can also represent it something like this. As I have told you, AC supply is given to this transformer and this is primary winding. Flux will be circulating in the core, flux produced due to current through the primary winding, and this is the iron core that you can see, and these are the secondary windings, and this is a load. So this is generally a representation of a transformer. What is the basic principle behind the operation of the transformer? The basic principle on which transformer works is Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction or mutual induction between the coils. What is that? A varying current in one coil of the transformer. A transformer produces a varying magnetic field, which in turn induces a varying electromotive force or voltage in the secondary coil. If you are applying voltage to the primary alternating voltage, it will set up a alternating current which sets up a magnetic field which will be linking with both the coils, and as a result of that a secondary EMF is induced in the secondary coil. This is mutual induction process. Now coming to auto transformer, till now we have seen what is a transformer, and now we are going to see what is an auto transformer. An auto transformer is a kind of electrical transformer where primary and secondary share same common single winding. Unlike in two winding transformer that we have seen in the previous slide, here we have only a single winding which is shared by both primary and secondary. So basically it's a one winding transformer. It does not have two windings unlike the previous case. So these are some of the variacs that are given. These are brushes and windings, and this is nothing but one of the auto transformer example. In an auto transformer, one single winding is used as primary winding as well as the secondary winding. This is the most important point in an auto transformer. In auto transformer, both primary winding and secondary winding are nothing but a single winding. But in two winding transformer, two different windings are used for primary and secondary purpose. Now this is the circuit of auto transformer, wherein you have only one winding, in which this is used as the total winding. Now is used as the primary winding to give the input voltage, and a part of this winding is utilized as the secondary winding. That means a voltage V2. Here the voltage V1 is greater than the voltage V2, so it is step down transformer, basically step down auto transformer. We will also see about that in types of auto transformer. This is the current I1 that is flowing because of V1, and if we can say the current is I2 in this case, therefore the current flowing through this will be I1 minus I2. So the total incoming current must be equal to the total outgoing current, and in this circuit, if you observe, I2 is the current that is flowing. This is I2 current that is coming here, and I1 is leaving. Therefore, current flowing through this will be I1 minus I2 according to Kirchhoff's current law. Now, why do we study this auto transformer? What are the advantages of going for an auto transformer? Is it requires less copper than two winding transformer. This is one of the advantage of auto transformer, wherein the copper is reduced, copper requirement is reduced, in turn the cost is reduced. Also, the operation of it is very high. The efficiency of this auto transformer is very high, and it also has the better voltage regulation, and it is of smaller size with same rating of a two winding transformer. These are some of the advantages of auto transformer. So we should learn about auto transformer. What are the types of auto transformers? One is step up transformer, the other one is step down auto transformer. Step up auto transformer and step down auto transformer. Here the same single winding, this is actually a single winding, this is also a single winding. In this case, if you apply voltage to the whole turns, all the turns, and if you take voltage across few turns, it is nothing but a step down transformer. That means the total voltage V1 is greater than V2, or number of turns, if you say N1 in this case, and number of turns here N2, N1 is always greater than here N2. The total winding, if you are taking N1 and this is N2. Similarly, if you are applying a voltage to few turns, and if you are taking the voltage across the, if you are connecting secondary winding completely across all the turns, it is nothing but a step up auto transformer. You'll apply voltage to a particular part and you'll take voltage across complete turns of the auto transformer. In both the cases, you can find only one winding which is shared by both the windings. One coil is shared by both the coils for primary and secondary purpose. Whole winding acts as secondary winding and tapered section acts as primary. In step up, as you can see in the previous slide, whole winding acts as secondary winding and a tapered section acts as a primary. And in step down transformer, whole winding acts as a primary winding and tapered section acts as a secondary winding. Now, what is the transformer ratio? As you can see, if I1 is the current flowing through this winding and V1 is the applied voltage, this is basically a step down transformer. And if you need to take I2 as current flowing through this and voltage across these two as V2. Now, if you say N1 is the number of turns in primary and N2 is the number of turns in secondary, the winding, these winding, number of turns in this winding is nothing but total N1 minus N2, that is N1 minus N2, and the applied voltage to the total winding is V1 and the voltage here is V2. And what is the voltage across these winding? It is total voltage minus this voltage will give you V1 minus V2. Now, according to transformer ratio, V2 by V1 minus V2 is equal to N2 by N1 minus N2. V1 minus V2 is equal to N2 by N1 minus N2. So if you cross multiply and simplify this, you'll get K is equal to V2 by V1 is equal to N2 by N1 is equal to I1 by I2. This is what you get, and this is called as the transformer ratio. Now, what is the output of a auto transformer? Basically, if you can see this transformer, the applied voltage is V1 and the voltage taken is V2. V1 is the voltage applied across the total windings and V2 is the voltage taken across the part of the winding. Now, total apparent power is equal to output power is V2 I2. Apparent power transfer inductively, there are two things here, inductive coupling and conductively coupling. So inductively it is V2 into I2 minus I1. This is V2 into I2 minus I1. And so here V2 can be written as, according to transformer ratio, K into V1, V2 is, and I2 can be written as I1 by K2 minus I1 is I1 is equal to K into V1 into, if you take I1 common, it is 1 by K minus 1. I repeat it, V2 can be written as K into V1 from transformer ratio. I2 can be written as I1 by K, it is transformer ratio, from the transformer ratio, minus I1. How do you get this V2 into I2 minus I1? It is a voltage V2 into, what is the current? I2 minus I1. The current flowing through this is I1 and this is I2. So what would be the current entering from this? This current plus this current must be equal to I2. So it is I2 minus I1. So if you add these two, you will get I2 according to KCL. So it is V2 into voltage across this winding into current I2 minus I1. So and we have written V2 is equal to K into V1 from turns ratio, and I2 is equal to I1 by K from turns ratio. And you get, if you take I1 common, it is VK V1 I1 1 by K minus 1. If you take the LCM and cancel out K, you'll get V1 I1 into 1 minus K. That means output apparent power transfer inductively is equal to input into 1 minus K. V1 I1 is the input power, and it is V1 input into 1 minus K. Apparent power transfer conductively is equal to input V1 I1 minus the apparent power inductively, that is input into 1 minus K. So input, if you are taking common, it is 1 minus 1 minus K. 1 1 will get cancelled, minus into minus will be plus, so K times of input. So the power transferred inductively is 1 minus K times input, and power transfer conductively is K times the input. Suppose the input power to an ideal transformer is 1000 watts and its voltage ratio is 0.25, then apparent power transferred inductively is equal to input, that is 1000, into 1 minus K. 1 minus 0.25 will give you 750. And conductively it is input into K, that is 1000 into 0.25 is 250. If you add these two, 750 and 250, you should get this 1000 watts. So this is the output of a auto transformer. What is the voltage rating of a auto transformer? Let us compare the voltage rating of two winding transformer and voltage rating of a two winding auto transformer when connected as auto transformer. Consider an auto transformer connected to the load as shown in the figure. This is basically a step down, as you can see, because input is given to the total winding and output is taken across a part of the winding. For the auto transformer, the turns ratio is K is equal to V2 by V1 is equal to I1 by I2 is equal to N2 by N1. This we have seen two slides before. And volt ampere rating, VA is volt ampere rating of an auto transformer is equal to V1 into I1 is equal to V2 into I2. If the same transformer is used as a two winding transformer with AC as primary and BC, AC this part as primary and BC this part as secondary, then volt ampere rating can be expressed as volt ampere rating of two winding, TW is two winding. Here AT means auto transformer, TW is two winding. So volt ampere rating a two winding transformer is equal to, here you can see voltage is V1 minus V2 into I1, and current is I2 minus I1 into V2. The current in this winding is I2 minus I1 into V2. And what is the voltage here? V1 minus V2 into I1. V into I is equal to V into I, you should say. So in this part, I1 must be multiplied by V1 minus V2, and V2 must be multiplied by I2 minus I1. Now if you simplify this, it is V1 into I1 minus V2 into I1 and I2 into V2 minus I2 I1 into V2. That is V1 minus V2 into I1 is equal to, if you see, V1 into I1 minus V2 into I1. But V2 is equal to K into V1 from this transformer ratio. V2 is equal to K into V1. So if you substitute this, V1 I1. V2 is KV1. KV1 I1 is I1 again. So this is, if you take V1 I1 common, it is 1 minus K into V1 I1. Therefore, the volt ampere rating of a two winding transformer is equal to 1 minus K times of volt ampere rating of auto transformer, or in other words, volt ampere rating of auto transformer is equal to 1 by 1 minus K times of voltage rating of two winding transformer. This is for a step down, as I told you, this is a step down transformer. You can also do it same for the step up transformer, you'll get almost the same. Now, what is the copper saving in an auto transformer? The copper saving in an auto transformer, as we have seen, the one of the advantage copper saving, the same output voltage and output and voltage transformation ratio, an auto transformer requires less copper than the two winding transformer. This is an two winding transformer, this is an auto transformer. As you can see, the winding requirement will be actually less saving of copper. Now weight of the copper required is proportional to here I1 into N1, I2 into N2. So I1 into N1 plus I2 into N2. This is the weight of the copper required, I current into number of turns plus current I2 into number of turns. This is in case of a two winding transformer. Now, when you come to auto transformer, weight of the copper required in section 122 what is this 1 to 2? The number of turns here is total turns is n1 and this turns is n2. So here it will be n1 minus n2 total minus n2. So it is n1 minus n2 into what is the current that is flowing? I1. So I1 into n1 minus n2. Similarly, weight of the copper required in section 2 to 3. In this, number of turns is n2. What is the current flowing through this? I2 minus I1. Because this current is I1, this is I2. So this current going in this direction will be I2 minus I1. Right? If you add this, some of the currents entering I1 plus I2 minus I1 will give you I2. So the current here will be I2 minus I1. So here the weight of the copper required is I2 minus I1 into N2. So I2 minus I1 into N2. So the total weight of the copper required is proportional to first one I1 into N1 minus N2. This I1 into N1 minus N2. And next plus N2 into I2 minus I1. So this is the expressions for weight of copper required for a two winding and auto transformer. Now if you want to simplify or get the relation between them, weight of the copper in auto transformer by weight of copper in ordinary transformer, auto transformer I1 into N1 minus N2 plus I2 minus I1 into N2. And if you simplify, you will get 1 minus 2 N2 I2 by 2 N1 I1. And if you cancel this I1 and 2 to 1 minus N2 by N1, what is N2 by N1? K, transformer ratio. Therefore, weight of copper in auto transformer is equal to, if you take this part to the right side, it is 1 minus K times of weight in ordinary two winding transformer. Now, what is the saving? This we have seen the relation. What is the saving? Now, what is saving in copper is equal to, this is weight of auto transformer. A is auto transformer. This is two winding transformer, ordinary transformer. So saving in copper is equal to, what is the saving? Ordinary the total actual transformer minus the auto transformer, that is WA minus W naught minus WA. What is WA again? WA is equal to, this is W naught actually, so W naught minus 1 minus K into W naught. So if it is K into W naught, saving of copper in auto transformer is equal to K times weight of copper in auto transformer is equal to K times weight of copper in saving in copper is equal to K times weight of the copper in ordinary transformer. Thus, if K is equal to 0.1, the saving of copper is only 10%, but if K is equal to 0.9, saving of copper is 90%. Therefore, near the value of K of auto transformer to 1, the greater is the saving of the copper. Conversion of two winding transformer into auto transformer. How do you convert a two winding transformer into auto transformer? There are two types. In one is additive polarity, that is it will give you, it is not step up, and the other one is subtractive polarity, it is step down. It is based on the mutual induction dot convention rule. So this is the additive polarity. Here you have taken a two winding transformer, if you connect this point to the primary, the secondary winding, a wire of secondary winding, I can say a terminal of secondary is connected to primary, and that will become an auto transformer. Either you can connect it, the terminal can be taken, common terminal can be taken here, or the common terminal can be taken here. In both the cases, it will behave as 2500, 250. That will be 2750. That means they are adding up. This is, let's say this dot terminal is plus and here is minus, and similarly this is plus and this is minus. And if you are connecting here, this is plus and this is minus, and here again it is plus and minus. According to KVL, you can see this voltage is 2500, then this is 250, so the total voltage will be 2750. And if even you can take this way, this is plus and here it is minus, and here again at dot it is plus and at this point it is minus. So these two are in additive polarity. If you add, you'll get 2750. So the equivalent will be, so this is the common point A, which is two input and output can be taken as of auto transformer, that we have represented here, as I can told you, and this is also same here. So in this, thus if input is V1, then the output is V1 plus V2 due to additive polarities. The auto transformer with additive polarity is a step up transformer. This you have to remember. The auto transformer with additive polarity is a step up transformer. Now subtractive polarity. if you connect in previously we have connected this to this point, now we are connecting these two here. That means here the polarity is negative, this is plus and this is minus, and here again this will be minus and this is plus, right? So this is subtractive polarity, 2500 250, this will give you 2500 minus 250, that is 2250. Or you can connect it down, same 2500 250, this is plus and this is minus, and minus and plus, that is both are in opposite, so it is 2250, 2500 minus 250. The same, the primary and secondary windings can be connected in series opposition like this, as I told you, these two, and you can connect the common point here. This will be dot will be plus, always remember, and this is minus, and here dot is plus and this is minus. That means plus minus minus plus, that means V1 and V2 are in opposite, V1 minus V2 will be the output. Now, the second type, that auto transformer with subtractive polarity is a step down transformer. This point you have to remember. The auto transformer with additive polarity is a step up. The auto transformer with subtractive polarity is a step down. And the voltage in subtractive will be V1 minus V2. In additive will be V1 plus V2. Now, what are the applications of this auto transformer? Used for starting induction motors, used as interconnecting transformers 132 kV by 330 kV, used as booster transformers, used for continuous variable supply, and there are so many other applications. These are the few applications that you can write in your exams. Now, when you compare auto transformer with a two winding transformer, you can expect a question like compare auto transformer and a ordinary or two winding transformer. Auto transformer has a single winding, it has two different windings for primary and secondary. The output voltage of given constant input can be varied from zero to maximum level. The output voltage can be varied only by varying the input voltage or tap changing. You cannot vary it like an auto transformer from zero to maximum. You can only vary it by using by changing the input voltage. Energy transfer occurs by conduction and induction. Energy transfer is only through induction. There is no sort of conduction because they are not connected physically in a two winding. Whereas in an auto transformer, they are connected physically. Therefore, you will have conduction and induction process. This is more efficient and economical. And this compared to auto transformer, this is less efficient. Although the transformers are very much efficient, when you compare it to the auto transformer, this is less efficient than auto transformers. Winding material, as we have seen, requirement is less. Winding material requirement is more compared to auto transformer. This point is very important. That is, when you compare it to auto transformer, it is more. Load connected to the auto transformer is electrically connected with source. Load connected to the auto this is not auto transformer, it's the transformer, is electrically isolated from the source. Wide range of voltage variations is possible, only small variations is possible. So this is what is auto transformer. We have seen what is a transformer, what is the basic principle of a transformer, Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction or mutual induction, and what is an auto transformer, what are the basic types of auto transformer, what is the turns ratio of the auto transformer, what is the volt ampere rating of the auto transformer, what is the output of an auto transformer, that is output is 1 minus k times into input, and conductively it is different, inductively it is different, and also we have seen what are the different types of auto transformers, what are the advantages of auto transformers, and what are the applications, and lastly we have seen what is the comparison between two winding and auto transformer, and how do you convert this two winding transformer to an auto transformer. So this is the end of the lecture 14, Basic Electrical Engineering, Unit 3, Auto Transformers topic. Thank you.